investigational journalism here that you couldn't have done. You guys can all look this up yourself.
We've seen what the difference is, you know, with people who show up at the Performance Institute, not just UFC fighters. There's other athletes in other sports that have been using the PI. And, you know, we opened the one in China. We got one now. We're starting to build right now in Mexico. I told you, I want to go to Africa with one. I want to go to Puerto Rico. So, yeah, the PI is a very critical piece to the UFC's success, and we're going to continue to open them.
If you truly want to be successful, one of the best ways to stand out is be positive. There's negativity all around this world. You hear it every single day. How often do you hear something positive on the news? Hardly ever. In fact, probably never, because they don't talk about it unless they have a small section of that news segment about something positive, and that's a quick 10 minutes on like an hour-long program talking about something positive. The rest is negative news. No matter where you look, you will find negativity, but you're not always going to find positivity. So that's up to you. Change that. Make that happen. Go out there and be the light of the world and change that mindset. Try to make people look at you in positivity and think the same thing. Because if you're always positive and you're always bright, having a good time, loving the life that was made to live, you are going to change the world. You're going to change somebody's perspective and make an impact, because there's so much negativity and darkness that if you just try a little bit to be a little positive, that's going to make a huge difference. And not only your life, but those around you. People will take notice and you will start to make a difference. And all while you're trying to become successful, all while you're putting in this time and energy and effort to truly enhance your future. It's not just about you, but it's about your mindset and how you're impacting others is what's truly important. Because the moment you start impacting others and affecting their day-to-day life and making a positive change on them, that's when the domino effect kicks in and everybody else starts having a good day. Everybody else starts feeling good. And it's truly, truly remarkable.
You know who, of all people, you know who calls me and tells me shit like that all the time? Is Bob Kraft. I love the fact that you're a Boston guy and you did this and you did that. I got Bob Kraft telling me that. I'm like, you've done pretty fucking well for yourself too. You know what I mean? That's Boston, man. That's how Boston people treat Boston people.
Yeah, well, that's always been my long-term goal. You know, this year we shattered the all-time pay-per-view record this year for a year, calendar year. And it'll end up being something like 8.6, 8.7 million pay-per-view buys in a year.
People like to push the buttons and talk about fighter pay, and you don't ever see us coming out and talking about it or doing whatever, because I don't give a shit. When I got 20-something-year-old Jake Paul talking about fighter pay, or you know, these other guys on the internet, we know what the hell we're doing over here. And at the end of the day, my philosophy is always this: is making none of these guys are under some type of gag order in their contract. Any fighter on the roster can come out and tell you guys what they make. Said this a million times.
One of the greatest fights that I've ever seen, and I expect the rematch to be just as good or better. And yes, to be in Madison Square Garden in New York for the first time since the pandemic, and more importantly to me, sold out is awesome.
You know, when we first bought this thing had such a bad stigma attached to it that venues didn't even want us to come there. So if you think about the time, the Trump brand is here, you know, the UFC brand is, you know, down here. He got it, he loved it, and he said, we'd love to have you here at the Taj Mahal, cut us a great deal, showed up for the first fight of the night and stayed till the last fight of the night, watched the whole show, both the shows that we did at the Taj, and then after that.
I truly believe that as, you know, technology continues to grow, the world gets smaller, and these companies, whether it's Netflix, Amazon, ESPN, who knows who it's going to be, over the next several years, there'll be 3 to 5 big players around the world where we can all watch the same thing at the same time, meaning the whole world can.
One of the other things we do and why we run real business is we reinvest in the sport. Not just the business of the UFC, but we reinvest in the sport, and we built a global business over the last 20 years. We have infrastructure. We have 450 employees that we hire. You know, a couple of years ago it was 350, we're at 450 now. UFC headquarters, Performance Institute.
I think the cable is going to go away. DirecTV will still be around, but streaming. You know, these guys that were the big players here in the United States, it's all going to change over the next several years. And you see a change in that. I mean, cord cutting started probably 5 years ago, and it's literally just gone like this. And the people who are out in front of it, the Netflix, Amazon's, ESPN, it's going to be interesting to see how it shakes out.
If you want to see more videos like these, please consider subscribing for more.